So besides your house, if you're a homeowner, then likely your retirement plan at work, your 401k, your company savings plan is probably your biggest chunk of your wealth. And even though I won't say their name often on this channel, Fidelity reported that at the end of 2016, that the average 401k balance was at a new high of $92,500. Now, ideally, you'd like to just let that money ride and make as much off of it as possible, but things happen. Now, no advisor is going to tell you to go and take money out of your 401k because it's not the fact that you're taking the money out. It's the fact that the money you took out is missing out on the growth over those years. It can't compound if you've got it in your bank account and not in the market. Now, in a perfect world, yes, you'd leave it there. It would grow. You would retire with $1 billion and spend your golden years however you want. But things happen usually when you least expect it, which means you're the least prepared for it. So let's talk about this. Now, first thing you should know is that there's actually a couple different ways that you can take money out of a 401k. There is the loan, which we're going to focus on today. There is a hardship distribution, and then there's just a straight up withdrawal. Now, if you absolutely have to take money out of your 401k, then you're probably going to want to choose the loan option. You'll be able to take out as much as 50% of your vested balance, or as much as $50,000, but remember, it's a loan. Now, if you were to just simply take the money out and make a withdrawal, then you're gonna lose 20% right off the top, plus another 10% as a tax penalty. It's just a lot of percents. You don't want that to happen. So let's avoid withdrawing the money. All right, so let's get into this. There are three times that I think it's okay for you to take money out of your 401k, but first, I want you to just double check, make sure you have no other access to any kind of emergency funds, money that you're hiding from the missus, anything before you go and take a loan out of your 401k. But if you have to, there's three times. Okay, so the first reason would be if something immediate happens where you need the money and you just weren't expecting it. You need a lot of money and you need it quick. A perfect example with this would be the high deductibles that you might have to pay on your healthcare plan. Now, if you have a high deductible healthcare plan, then you really should probably consider a health savings account so that you could start building up money to pay for that deductible inevitably when you're gonna have to use it. But what if you are saving and you just didn't save enough and all of a sudden something happens to you or a family member and you need to pay that high deductible? Then it's cool. Go to your 401k if you have no other money, borrow the money from that. We don't want you getting in any credit problems just because you can't pay a deductible. All right, the second reason you could take money out of a 401k, and this one's okay, this is not the best one here, but if you need cash for some immediate reason, and your credit score maybe temporarily is taking a bit of a hit, so you can't go get a loan and get a decent interest rate, right? You're gonna pay an interest rate on your 401k loan, but I'll bet you it's gonna be a lot less than some bank is gonna charge you if you don't have the greatest credit. Just remember, you only have 5 years to pay that 401k loan back. Don't borrow more than you can handle because you've got 5 years to pay it back. And the last reason I say that it's okay to take a loan from your 401k would be if you are serious, and I mean really serious, about paying off some long-term high-interest credit card debt. If you've got a plan, then you might want to go into that 401k to start that plan. See, the loan on your 401k is going to have an interest rate that I guarantee you is going to be lower than what you're paying for your credit cards. So if you're really serious about paying off credit card debt and you've just got a plan, you're going to work for it, you're going to stop at nothing to get it paid off, then of course you got to do whatever it takes to get the lowest interest rate that you can and knock out all the high interest rate credit cards. So in that case, I say go for it. Now remember, this is a loan. It's not a gift, it's not a withdrawal, it's a loan and you do have to pay it back. In fact, it's gonna come right out of your paycheck every time you get paid at your job. So be sure and not take a loan if you know you're gonna leave your job. Because if you leave your job at any point during the term of this loan, they're gonna be like, hey, we need that money back and you've got 60 days to do it. Don't do that. But if you do leave your job, you pay back all the money within the 60 days, and now you want to roll it over to an IRA, right here, baby. This is what this guy does. I roll it over to an IRA for you, and of course, there's no charge. There's never any fees for doing that. I'll help you with every step along the way. Now, at some point, you may want someone to manage that IRA for you, and wouldn't you know it, that's what we do here at Jazz Wealth. So If you'd like some help with that, just go to jazzwealth.com. Up at the top, click Invest Now. I will personally follow up with you to help get your account open or roll that 401k over from wherever it might be. If you have more questions, like to say a few nice things, or tell me I've lost my marbles, go to the bottom, leave a comment. You can always send me an email if you just personally want to make fun of me, or you can always call me directly at